okay, my friends, let's attack this idea of measuring deviation or variation from an average. So I've got on the board, I've got Ernie's data points, and I've got Bert's data points. I'm gonna try to start sneaking subscripts in on you, just because they're all over statistics. You'll often see little tiny subscripts. They don't mean anything other than a label. So X sub Ernie just means Ernie's data points, and X sub Bert just means Bert's data points. Okay, so we're gonna measure deviation from the mean. Deviation from the mean. So let's look at Ernie first. These are Ernie's data points. Now, you might not remember this from yesterday's videos, maybe you do, but these have an average of 81, as do Bert's. That was one of the challenges yesterday, was that Ernie and Bert both have the same average. So let's start by looking at how different Ernie's test scores are from the average. We're going to look at each test score and take the difference of that score and the average. All right, so I'm gonna make a little column right here called X minus X bar. And what that is just we're gonna take each of Ernie's test scores and subtract the average of 81. So this is gonna be 80 minus 81, which is gonna be -1. There's the first deviation right there. And all that means is that score is one below average. 81 minus 81 shouldn't be a surprise. That's gonna be 0. That is at average. 83 minus 81 is going to be +2. It's 2 above average. 79 minus 81, -2, 2 below. And 82 minus 81 is going to be 1 above. So what those numbers are the individual deviations from average of Ernie's 5 test scores. I'm going to put a little squiggly line here between Bert and Ernie, if that's okay. We'll get to Bert in a second. So now what do we do with these numbers? If you get you can get a visual of these numbers, if you remember that dot plot that we looked at in the PowerPoint, the average is right in the middle, and then the plus and minus ones are right next to it, and then the plus and minus twos are right next to that. But how do you talk about the deviation of the entire data set? Because that's what you want to do. You want to get kind of a similar number. So one thing you might want to do, like we did with center, is average these. And the only problem with that is, if you try to average these, look what happens. -1 plus 0 plus 2 plus -2 plus 1. If you add that up, it adds up to 0. And 0 divided by 5 is 0, which means if you use these numbers, you're average deviation from the mean is going to be nothing. And that you might say to yourself, well, Sean, that's just because it's this data set. But check this out. It's actually not because it's this data set. Let's look at Bert's too. I'm going to speed this up a little bit to get the process quicker. There's Bert's deviations. Now, Bert's deviations are larger, more positive, and more negative than Ernie's, but that makes sense because you remember you noticed that in the previous videos. But the problem is, it appears as though when you look at the deviations from average of both of these, the deviations always sum to 0. And not to ruin the surprise, but that'll always happen. It doesn't matter which data set you're dealing with. If you analyze the data set in this way, whether it's 5 data points or 5,000 data points, the sum of the deviations from average will always be 0. Now, the first thing I want you to do is I want you to think about that, get some thoughts. I'm going to ask you about that later. The next thing is, this creates a problem. Because if no matter what the data set is, if this happens, then if we try to sum up, I want to use that fancy sigma symbol, if we try to sum up the deviations from average, if it always equals 0, then we can't use that as a measure of deviation. Because it's going to make every data set look like it has 0 deviation. And the only way a data set can have zero deviation is what? Think about that too. What's the only way a set of numbers can have zero deviation? Scratch down your answer to that. I'm going to ask you about that in the homework. Then we got to deal with this issue.